Hello guys, welcome to my channel Tech Transform. So today we are here to do some of the coolest things using Pig. We are going to find out the oldest 5-star movie using Pig. Remember in one of the last video I have shown you how to download the movielens dataset and install into the Hadoop SDFS directory. We are going to use those SDFS movielens dataset files and find the oldest 5-star movie using Pig. So let's get started. So let me open my terminal and check whether all those Hadoop daemons are running or not. This is the first step we are going to do. JPS. So okay, it's running. If in your case it's not running, you can type start-dfs.sh, start-yarn.sh, start-all.sh in order to start the JPS. So in my machine it's running. We need to check whether I have all those movielens datasets files or not. Basically we are going to deal with the data. I will show you what type of data we are looking for. So let's go inside work datasets. This is our ML100K data. Here we have u.data. Oh, see, this is the data. This is the movie data. Okay. So you can see here we have user ID, movie ID, the ratings given by that user, and on what timestamp. So, and there is one more. U.item. So this is basically the movie lookup. So for each movie ID, what is the movie name and what is the IMDb link for that and what is the release date. Okay, so this is in my local file. Let's check whether it is in the SDFS directory or not. For that, Hadoop fs minus ls. So see, we have this ML. Let's go inside this folder and find what are the files inside that. ML100K. Okay, so I have these two files, u.data and u.item. So u.item is containing the movie user ID, movie ID, rating, and date timestamp. And u.item is containing the movie ID, movie name, IMDb link, and release date. So let's start with our basic scripts. The first, what we have to do, we have to find this ratings. So this is what I am doing here. I am loading this data set. So no, we have first, before that, we have to enter inside Pig in map reduce mode. For that, Pig semicolon. Right now we are in Pig grunt cell. Let's execute script one by one. I have created all the script in a one script file. Later what we'll do, first we'll see what each script is doing, and later we'll execute this whole script at a one and see the final output and see the final oldest 5-star movies. So in order to make you clear, let's run one by one. So this is what controls I'm doing. Control C, copy this. So here what we are doing, we are loading the u.data item from SDFS directory using Pig storage because it is tab delimited. So I am giving separator as tab delimited and giving the I am attaching a schema, schema to it also. So user ID, movie ID, first is, remember we open the file, first one, first column is user ID, movie ID, rating time. So enter. Okay, so what I will be doing, I am not going to dump directly all the records because it is going to take a lot of time. So I will, for that I want to limit some records. So for that, ratings, because once we do like this dump record and semicolon enter, it will take a lot of time to execute. It will take a lot of time to execute. So let's limit the record first, then we'll dump in order to get the result faster. So for that, we used to limit the record. So for that, the syntax is ratings let's say I'm giving a different bag name, ratings underscore record is equal to limit rating one zero, enter. Dump rating underscore records. Okay, some issue is there. Ratings underscore remit. Okay, yeah, we have done mistake here. My original bag was ratings. Okay, now let's dump this rating underscore record. Dump ratings underscore record. So see, finally we got this 10 records. It contains 1 lakh records, but we are printing right now 10 only. So you can see all those movie dot data, it's here. So all those movie id user id rating and all this coming here. So we have this bag will containing all those data related to u dot data. Let's load an error. It's the metadata. Why I'm calling here metadata is because, let me clear the thing. So what we are doing here, we are loading the u dot item. It's basically containing the movie id and movie name. So enter into that. Okay, let's again print only the 10 metadata underscore record is equal to limit metadata 10. Okay, now dump. So you got that. We have this 10 records having this movie ID, movie name. Now let's move the next step. So next step, what we have to do from this metadata is giving you movie ID, movie title, release date, video release, IMDb link, but we don't need all these things. We need only movie ID, movie title, and release date in different format. So for that we are going to remember in last video I have given a demo of all those basically big Latin script command. So here we are doing for each to get the only columns movie ID and movie title. We are not bothering about all the columns. So in order to fetch some columns from the bag metadata, we should use for each command. So what we are doing here, we are fetching movie ID, movie title, and we are converting the release date to particular format of the timestamp as release time. Okay, so we got that name lookup. So name, after that what we are going to do, we are going to ratings by movie. What we are going to do, we are going to this ratings, we are going to group in a group based upon movie ID. So finally we will get all those movie details grouped in a movie ID. So for particular movie ID, how many users have given rating? Let's say for first user ID, 3 users have given rating. So it will create a group like 1 movie ID 1 comma then all the ratings for that particular movie ID. Then we can find out the average ratings. For average ratings, what we have to do, we again have to do for each. And again creating a group as movie ID. So what we are going to do is getting movie ID and finally calculating the average rating for each movie ID. So basically in this average rating bags we have movie ID and the average ratings for each movie. Then what we are going to do, we are going to find the 5-star movies. For 5-star movies, what we have to do, we have to apply filter, and based upon that filter average ratings this bag by average rating greater than 4.0. by this we will be getting the greater than 4.0 movie ratings. Now what we have to do, we have to in this we have only movie ID and movie ID and the average rating. What we have to do, we have to replace with this movie ID with the actual movie name. So for that, what we have to do, we have to join these two bags. So five stars with data means join 5-star movies. This bag containing movie ID, average ratings, by movie ID, comma, name lookup. Name lookup is nothing, just movie ID, movie title, and the release time. So, and based upon movie ID, we are joining these two bags. Now, what we have to do? We have to find the oldest 5-star movies. For that, what we are going to do? We are applying order clause. So, order 5 stars with data by name lookup colon release time. So, release time is nothing. This time, based upon release time, we are ordering the 5-star with data bag. Finally, we are going to dump this old 5-star movies data, and we'll get that all those 5-star movie data, 5-star rated movie data, old 5-star movie rated data we will get finally. So because for running each script is going to take time, so what I have done, I have created a file with .pig extension. You can see oldest 5-star movies .pig. So this is a pig extension. We can run run this whole script, pig script file, in our command prompt. So what we have to do for this, let's come out this grunt quit. Let's first copy the path desktop slides. Then this is the pig file. We are copying this, copy home. Then come here. If in order to run the .pig file, we should type pig control shift v, the location of that particular .pig extension, and enter. So what it will do, it will go and internally run a lot of MapReduce job in order to do all those statements what we have written, and it will finally give you the oldest five stars movie data. So this is gonna be very cool, and we are going to see how much time it will take. So it is going to take approx 10 to 11 minutes of time for that. For the time being, I am just pausing my video and will resume back once I have the result. So finally, you can see our job is completed. So pig scripts got executed. This script got executed, and it took 11 minutes 47 seconds and 508 milliseconds to run. And finally, we have the desired output. We can see in the output we have the movie's oldest 5-star rated movie in a order. See, so these are the movies. So you can see you can treat this as a result. So see, this Thin Man is a movie in 1934. This was rated as 4.15, then 4.01 rating, and its movie name was It Happened One Night in 1934. So that's very pretty cool result we are going to see here. So finally, we have this data having oldest movie with a 5-star rating using pig. So that's all for today. If you really liked it, please subscribe and share. Thanks for watching. Have a good day. Bye.